So I'm not much of an artist, but this is the kind of aesthetic that I want. I want very vibrant colors. That's what I'm going for. Unfortunately, by default, Godot looks like this. Not very interesting. So, how can we go from this to this? Let's find out. There are three things that we need in order to get this effect. First of all, it's the directional light, and it creates the shadows and adds depth to the scene. Without it, it looks like this. Next, we'll have to set up the world environment properly. It's the world environment that actually makes the colors vibrant. This is how it looks with the default environment, and this is what we want. Finally, we have a color rect that creates the vignette effect, which is very simple, but has a tremendous effect. Let's look at each of them. First, for the directional light, there are really only two settings that are important. We need to increase the energy, because we wanted the scene to be much brighter, so I set it to 2. And secondly, we need to remember to enable shadows. And that's it, really. The only thing you need to remember is to consider the angle of your light. You'll want the light to hit the character and the scene in such a way that it brings out the stuff that you want to see. Next, we'll look at the environment. Just a note, I'm using a simple cloudy sky as the background. It's not even HDR. The most important thing is the ambient light. By default, there isn't actually any ambient light. You can see the color is black. Instead, all the ambient light comes from sky contribution, and that's why we get this blue tint that we really don't like. So what we're going to do is remove the sky contribution and instead have white ambient light. This makes the scene very bright, despite not actually having the directional light enabled. So we'll set down the ambient energy to 0.5. Next we'll look at tone map. This is what will make our colors vibrant. We'll set it to ACS, or ACs, I don't know. But as you can see, the colors become very bright. Filmic is also very popular, but for the kind of look I'm going for, ACS is the one. If you're using HDR, you'll probably want to increase the white point. Next is screen space ambient occlusion. This gives our scene a lot more feeling, as you can see. When we turn on the light, we can see that the screen space ambient occlusion almost goes away, and so we can turn up light effect, and it comes back. Finally, we'll enable glow. I usually leave it at default, and look at if I need to change them later. Finally, we have the vignette effect. The vignette is simply a soft circle that adds a bit of darkness towards the edge and especially corners, and it looks like this. It doesn't come built in with Godot right now, but you can create it with a color rect. Remember to set mouse filter to ignore, otherwise you won't be able to click on anything. The shader is a simple canvas item with a radius and a softness parameter. We simply calculate a circle based on the length from the center, and then we use a smooth step to define the effect. We can either mix it with the screen texture, or we can simply use transparency, as I've done here. And there we go. We can see that the directional light makes a huge difference to the way our scene looks. However, we can also see that it's actually the world environment that gives us the vibrant colors. Together, it looks very well, especially when you also enable vignette. I hope you learned something. See you next time.